I can smell a perfume.
My mum wears this perfume.
It's in the sheets. What? Bummer, I can't have sex in her sheets.
So I wanted to get the thought of my mum out of my head before I got intimate with her.
I will change the sheets. You go into the shower and get yourself squeaky clean so we can get ready for some fun. Go.
Now. I had this sexy nightie that I got out. I went off and got some sheets out of the cupboard. I'm lying in my nightie or looking all sexy and ready to go.
Jason, you look scrumptious, baby, and I have you all to myself.
And then all of a sudden...
Dale!
And the worst thing with mums, she doesn't have locks on her doors.
No.
Everything all right, man? Need anything?
Everything's fine, Mum. We're settling in.
Alrighty then, 99.
So we've had to barricade our suitcase right against the door. So if we hear the suitcases fall over, get off quick.
A lot of preparation for just one hot, sexy night.
Stop, stop, stop.
When he stopped me,
What?
I was thinking that his mum was out the door again. And I was like, nothing's wrong, everything's fine, your mum's not there.
Stop, stop, I don't feel good.
What?
My hands are all clammy and face is sweating and my heart was going 100 miles an hour. So I said, look, there's something seriously wrong with me. And then I looked down and
I see... Turn around, sweetie, show me.
It was already swollen in the heat of the moment.
Show me what's wrong.
I couldn't explain what had happened.
What? They were like grapefruits, maybe? And getting bigger.
What's wrong with me?
And because he was clutching his chest, I thought he was having a heart attack.
What is wrong? What?
It was a bit scary.
Dale? What's going on? What's all this commotion about? Dale, are you naked?
I didn't know whether I was going to die from a heart attack or die of embarrassment with my whole family there.
What is it, son? Is it your chest?
What's going on, mate? You all right?
I was thinking we've got to get him to the hospital.
I got a real tightness in my chest. I think I'm having a heart attack.
Oh, my God. Better get your pants on, son.
They won't fit.
What? I don't understand.
I borrowed one of Dad's robes.
How could your pants not fit? Does this have something to do with
it? Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
And you walked very slowly to the car.
Okay, I'm going to take him to the hospital.
Luckily, it was only a short drive.
Thank God, we made it.
Yes, it's here. Look, go straight through.
And there's a sign saying that it's closed. Because it's a public holiday. Small town, 350 people max.
We looked at each other and we're like...
Can it get any worse?
What are we going to do?
My heart! Look. My family jewels!
Okay.
I don't think I'll get some
baby, we're going to work something out. Dale! Look.
I mean, I was freaking out.
Yes, hello. Yes, please, it's an emergency.
Just a million things go through your head. What's going on?
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
It is scary.
It's okay, just need to breathe through it, okay? Okay, you're going
to
be fine.
So I thought, what if I die at that time? Is something seriously wrong with me?
That 10-15 minutes went pretty quickly.
I'm so sorry. I'm the only one here today. I got here as quickly as I could. What seems to be the problem?
It was actually a nurse that showed up.
My chest is tight. I can't breathe.
But he's having chest pains. He's sweating all the time. Okay, let's get you inside. Can you stand up?
Am I having a heart attack?
We'll find out. You're going to need a complete blood workup, so I called in the lab technician. You're okay. Come on.
I had to get a few tests.
We'll take good care of you.
She hooked him up to some monitors just to check the heart rate and took some blood.
The heart monitor's stable. Does that mean I'm not having a heart attack?
It doesn't tell the whole story, so we're going to have to do a blood test for enzymes to settle the case.
What about a doctor?
We're fairly rural out here. The closest doctor's about 100 kilometres away on holiday. But don't worry, you're in good hands. I've done this before. What was happening when the pain first began?
We were kind of having some alone time, if you know what I mean.
I see. And then what happened?
I suddenly got a terrible tightness and pain in my chest. I couldn't breathe. Sweat was pouring down my face and I felt nauseous.
Okay, anything else?
There's something else. Mm-hmm. Down there, keeps getting bigger.
And bigger.
Okay, well, let's have a look.
it was so swollen.
Just show me. Oh, wow.
So then Mum called us.
It's your mum. What should I tell her?
Tell her that he is fine for now and that we'll know something for certain as soon as we get the blood test back.
What do you think?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like this before.
She's poking at it.
Can you feel that?
Yeah, I can feel it.
Yeah. Yep, it's getting bigger. Yes, Mum, I'm talking about his privates.
Well, I'm gonna get to keep my plumbing.
She's having a bit of a play around with it, really.
Please hold still.
Ah!
Oh, that was my fault. I'm just trying to figure out what's causing the worrisome swelling and how it relates to your other symptoms, but for right now, I'm at a loss.
The possibility of what it could be is all these things going through your mind. I'm worried about my chest. I think I might be having a heart attack.
So it was kind of guessing and waiting for test results to see what it would come up with.
I have your labs, and I'm happy to say that you did not have a heart attack.
I was very relieved to hear her say that.
And there's no sign of bacterial infection.
Good.
I'm sorry, I really have no idea what's going on with your testicles, but seeing as you're having chest pain and the sweats, it appears as though you're having some sort of allergic reaction.
When someone comes in with allergic reactions, it's important to treat them right away. We need to decrease their exposure to the allergen and decrease that inflammatory process. We're usually just treating the symptoms and we don't really know what the person's actually allergic to.
After we found out the heart was okay, it was
focus
on the crown jewels.
Well, this is an epinephrine injection. And this should reduce the effects of the allergy so that we can figure out the cause. Now, hopefully, the ice pack will reduce the swelling so that I can get a better look of what's going on down there.
Prolonged orchitis, or swelling of the testicles, can lead to infertility. If left untreated, the patient has difficulty urinating, and that could lead to kidney damage.
After the EpiPen, wasn't sweating as much.
He seemed a lot calmer.
How are we doing?
His chest is better, but he's still pretty swollen downstairs.
Okay, well, let's take a look.
I had to maintain eye contact with her.
Watching someone else touch your husband's crown jewel, it's kind of odd.
Just lifting things and it's just very uncomfortable.
Well, the swelling has gone down enough for me to see a small red lump on the left testicle. I bet that's the culprit. And on the small red lump, I can see two tiny bites from two tiny fangs. That would explain the allergic reaction.
Two tiny what?
Fangs. You've been bitten by a spider.
Oh my God. How did a spider get down there?
An arm, yeah. A leg, but not down there.
Well, certain spiders like to hide out in clothes, cupboards, towels, sheets.
I hadn't thought about it, but when she mentioned the sheets, that was the first thing that came to my mind.
Sheets? We were copping a root in Mum's bed last night. After we changed the sheets.
That's probably where the spider was. Whitetail spiders are pretty common in Southeast Australia, and they get into everything. And they don't spin webs, so sometimes they're pretty hard to spot.
It happens a lot in Australia, people getting bitten by spiders, but not in your privates.
No.
You know, that's your bad luck.
Luckily, whitetail spider bites aren't deadly, but you had a pretty severe allergic reaction, so it's lucky you came in when you did, because allergic reactions can also be deadly.
This whole time, I am still thinking how long they're going to be swollen for. Are we going to be able to get back to Mum's bedroom and finish what we started?
That was actually the last thing on my mind.
The first thing on my mind.
Unfortunately, ice is the only treatment for a whitetail spider bite, and the swelling could stay like that for a few weeks. So it looks like sex is off the table for you two until Dad returns to normal.
They said, when you get back to the city, get an ultrasound just to make sure everything's working in working order. So just kept applying ice to that, and eventually it went away and stuff, and everything's good.
Well, so much for our romantic vacation.